What's up, guys? This is HotTide7RCT. even though you see the usual setup right here for streams, and even though I will be streaming a little bit later on, we're doing Tekken 7 for you guys. Just wanted to take this opportunity to speak with you guys about some things that I have on my chest I want to bring out. No edits, no slick music and transitions, nothing like that of that sort. I'll leave that up to more talented YouTubers out there who know how to mess around with that stuff. This is more along the PSA, public service announcement kind of thing, but more geared towards gamers and people of my age. Let's say age bracket, let's say between 30s, 40s, whatever, you know, old school gamers. But of course, it applies and it'll encompass all sorts of gamers from everywhere. So just bear with me here. So much so that even, guys, I made a special camera mode so I can be more up front and close about this. Now, why am I doing this? Just for a little bit of context. I'll try not to take too long. I'm doing this today because this is basically drawn from inspiration from a person who is very close and dear to me. I'm speaking, of course, of some of you know her from some of my gaming, older video gaming videos and stuff that I've done. She's AfroSoul. Just in case, you know, so you guys are wondering, she's okay, she's nice, you know, she's doing well. It's just that she's taking up a new project, something that's called Life at 45, which will be encompassed by a video game channel, not a video game channel, oh my god, YouTube channel, a blog, and some other stuff that she's going to be working on. Now, this is completely something different from what we guys here at RCT do, but it's something that I really want to support because it's something that affects us. At least the themes and the stuff that she's going to be talking about there affects people like us from our age bracket. Now, getting that out of the way, I drew inspiration from what she's doing to do this, but hopefully it's going to be a short video. Again, since this is no edit, there's no edit, no script, no nothing, I'm just going to go forward with it. So, what is this video all about? Well, basically, this is me, unassuming, as you can see by the name up there. Where is it? There you go. HotTide7. That's the way you pronounce it, HotTide7. It's not Hated7 or any other variant. I think that you assume that if I came up with the name, I can be able to pronounce it any way I want to. So it's HotTide7. As you guys know, I've been doing YouTube videos for quite some time and doing some streams. I am a small channel, of course, like many, many others. My background is fairly simple. I am a what you would call old school hardcore gamer. Now, what is that? Well, basically, what I consider that to be is a gamer who was in the gaming industry, who was partook of the gaming hobby, if you will, from a very, very early age, let's say right after the crash of 83, up until the point of today, and has been part of that in different stages of a person's life. That's me. That's basically me. Around the time that the video game crash happened, I was around about 13, 14 years old. So I wasn't small enough to not know what was going on. I was somehow aware, even though there wasn't, not by a long shot, the tools and the social media available of today. We only had, you know, magazines and stuff like that, which would deliver the news basically like a month or two basically late because of the printing issues and stuff like that. But what I mean by this is that I was part of that and I got to live it. I got to be a part of that, just like many thousands, if not millions, of other people, gamers. some of which I have been blessed by knowing through this social media. People like, I'm going to make just examples, not that it's everybody, but some examples like Aaron Classic Gamer, Lowen Rice, Anthony Durso from the NeoGeo forums, etc., etc. These are people who, just like me, have a very deep-seated love and passion for the video game industry, has seen it grow, or let's say be reborn into what it is today, and we have seen it evolve. Now, the reason why I'm doing this video, which I hope kind of like clicks with a lot of you people out there. If it doesn't, well, you know, at least I tried. Like I said in the beginning, I'm a very unassuming person. I tend to be towards the humble aspect of things. I don't really need, even though I am a person who has been involved in the tech community. I have my studies, I have a bachelor's degree in computer science, and I have been following tech for a long, long time. I love hardware, I love software, and above everything else, I love games. Now, I am going to try not to turn this into a rant, but basically have a one-sided conversation, since you cannot answer me unless you do in the comments, which I will appreciate. There's a couple of things that I want to bring forward. Number one is, why did everything have to turn into shit? And I will go into a short explanation very, very shortly. Why did it turn to shit? What I mean by that is, back in the day, we had, of course, there's always competition in all kinds of sports, politics. We see it every day. There's always going to be competition. There's always going to be factions and sides and stuff like that. But man, oh man, it has never been so apparent and so prevalent than in today's time. Everything from social media to even YouTubers and video games and everything is so saturated by having these invisible wars going on. Now, I know no kind of bitching and complaining is going to make it go away. That's something that's unfortunate, but it's here to stay and you have to live with it. But I think that I've, in some sort of delusional way, have earned my place, and I am able to at least complain about it, even if just a little bit, just so to see if I can find anybody, which I know there must be a lot of you guys out there who feel the same way. Now, specifically, there's always going to be competition, like I mentioned, between companies, especially big companies, media companies, like, of course, we have Sony, Nintendo, and Microsoft. Now, just in case you were wondering, this is not about Sony fanboys, Microsoft fanboys, and Nintendo fanboys, because that would be another video on itself. But the dynamics of what makes that happen is basically what I'm trying to bring out, or trying to basically complain about. As a gamer, I think the statement would go as follows. As a long-standing, old-school, hardcore gamer, I feel very disappointed and I feel very frustrated and angry that the console wars, gaming wars, / whatever social media crap, I wish it would stop. We have been participated in so many things that has been outright really crappy. Like, we have everything from Gamergate to Resolution Gate to everything that you could add or attach a gate to. It has been thrown upon the gaming industry, and it has been mixed up, and in turn hasn't been very good for gaming in general. Now, another dynamic which I've been despising for quite some time is the fact that, on the one hand, you have these companies that we have grown up with in many senses. We have these companies who have put forward some amazing games and titles, and they are being lost in the sea of this generation of whiny, crappy, let's throw and sling mud and shit and everything towards that, just to deny that little bright spot of gaming for their own means and agendas. Again, I don't want to be part of any politics, or I'm not trying to create any controversy. I'm just trying to voice what I feel. It's very, very wrong about what's going on in the industry. Now, for a little bit of more context, like I said, I am part of the tech community. I am part of the gaming community. I'm not a big part. I just, you know, try to wiggle myself into there and try to be part of, or create some kind of community where we can all have some fun. Because, to be honest, besides being the gamer, I am a person. I can say with confidence that I am living the American dream, quote unquote. Look around me, guys. It is not a mansion. It's just a small apartment. I have my little microwave and coffee maker over there. I hate my job. So yeah, that should qualify me as living the American dream. And what I come to after doing those grueling hours, as you can tell by my little course, my voice, because I have been sick this past week working through, and now I have a day off. So when I get out of work and I forget about these things, I just want to go into gaming, appreciating and having fun, escaping like everybody else, I assume, does when they go into gaming. And having to encounter so much crap, it's really, really, it kind of deflates your feelings, your energy, basically, for gaming in general. Now, it's not something that it does not have a solution. It's not something that you could completely not avoid, because you could. But it's something that when you try to be part of every aspect of the video game industry, if you're just playing for a couple of hours a week and you just boot up your favorite console or maybe your PC for a few Steam games or whatever, it really shouldn't affect you. But when you go into the social aspect and you go, let's say, follow up a game or a company or something because there's an upcoming game that you really want to see have success, or you're really hyped up because that thing is being made, and you have to go through all of these hoops and all of this crap that people just throw in. It's just people, just, you know, trolls and people, haters, who just want to see that specific person or company or even game not succeed because of some deep-seated hate or whatever. It's really messed up, and it shouldn't be that way. That's basically all I'm trying to say. Seeing how many companies have evolved, everything from the rise and fall of Atari, the rise and somewhat fall of Nintendo, the rise and definitely fall of Sega, and then rise back again to the advent of the Sony Microsoft time onto the very present, you can see that this is an industry that is here to stay. People like us who have been gaming from the very beginning, we had no doubts that was going to be it, because we felt it in our bones back then when we had our 16-bit consoles. Even with the 8-bit consoles, we saw that there was some kind of magic. I just hope that this magic continues. I see a ray of hope, because I see in the indie community, I see them working really, really hard, going through some of those hoops that I've mentioned, just to bring their game, their vision out for you guys. And I see a ray of hope in that. I hope that that will carry the industry forward, and it will push the big companies like Sony and Microsoft and Nintendo to be a better themselves, you know, a better versions of who they are for the sake of the industry. Because let's be honest, it is a very, very huge and very encompassing industry as a whole, and I would like to see it be here for a very long time. Now, if this video made absolutely no sense whatsoever for you, then dismiss it. If it did kind of click to you and you have something you would love to add, I would appreciate if you would leave a comment down below, like and subscribe, and I'll see you guys later with the stream. I will be doing the Tekken stream very soon, and again, I just wanted to share this with you guys because it's really draining sometimes. Sometimes you try to come on and do a video or do a stream and stuff, and you get hit with so much negativity and so much hate. Again, not targeting or specifying which company is getting the hate and which company or which side is dishing out the hate, but the hate in general is very nasty. Aside from that glimmer of hope that I mentioned in the indies, I'm gonna come right out and say it. The advent of the Switch launch this year, because it is what, 2017 when I'm doing this video, gives me another ray of hope, and that is that here is this underpowered system coming out, and we are seeing a resurgence of old school genres coming back to life. We are seeing, in some way or form or fashion, beat 'em ups coming to the forefront again. We're seeing shoot 'em ups coming to the forefront again. And fighters, even though fighters were always there, we're going back to old school stuff because companies, wow, I can't believe it, mind blown, they're saying, holy crap, there are people who really want this stuff. So maybe, yes, we were sitting on franchises that were amazing. Let's make some money out of it. So hopefully we will get to see, I will get to see my dream games in the form of another 2D or 3D Metroid. I'm going to see a new Castlevania for the Switch. I'll see, I don't know, something of a Final Fight, which I already saw. I've seen a couple of indies that are up and coming with new games in that genre that are making me feel really, really good about. But anyways, I digress. The point is, guys, we are gamers. Let's come together. Let's forget about all this negativity crap. Let's turn this generation of whiners and haters and just, you know, gray cloud bringers of doom and disappointment. Let's push that all away. Let's have fun. Let's be brothers and sisters and the gaming community, and let's help each other out instead of just throwing mud and dirt. And basically that's it. That's all I have to say. So take care, guys. I'll see you next time, and please like and subscribe and comment. And by the way, as a last minute thing, once again, I want to thank Norman Pena, better known as Afro Soul. Wish her good luck in her new venture in life at 45, and I'm gonna be there. I'm gonna be supportive, and hopefully some of you guys will, you know, feel something to identify with and are gonna be able to support her as well. Also, I'm trying to make a transition from YouTube to Vidme, so if any of you guys can give me a sub over there so I can make the verification process, I really would appreciate it. So yeah, basically that's it for now. End of PSA/gamer announcement, and hope to see you guys soon. Take care. Bye.